a video in which graphical transformation will be there. So instead of just taking graphical transformation, I decided to take up a question in which many such concepts will be covered. So this will be a long video, but it will cover many of your concepts. So let us start with the video. The set of values of k, where k belongs to real number, for which this equation will have exactly 4 real roots. Right now you need to understand that there should be 4 real roots. First of all, let me tell you, fx minus a equal to 0. Let us say this is the equation. Then let me say fx has this curve and this particular value. This is treated as a function. Let me say this is y equal to a and this is y equal to fx. So I split this particular thing into two functions. Now y equal to a, let us say, is this line. It means fx and a are equal at this point. So at this point, fx minus a will be equal to 0. So how many solutions? Only one solution. Okay, I hope you got this. But I will take a nice example to make this concept more clear. Because everybody knows the graph of sine x. So what I'll do is, let me say, phi sine x minus 3 equal to 0. How many solutions in 0 to 2 pi? So let me divide both sides by phi. So it will be 3 by phi equal to 0. Now, sine x. I will consider fx as sine x and this as gx as 3 by phi. I'll draw both the graphs. From 0 to 2 pi, I will draw sine x like this because they have asked me 0 to 2 pi. And the next graph is 3 by phi. It means y equal to 3 by phi. Now, this particular value is 1. So 3 by 5 is 0.6. So 0.6 will be over here. So this is your y equal to 3 by 5. Basically what we did is we drew y equal to sine x and we drew y equal to 3 by 5. How many points they are cutting each other? 1 and 2. It means there are 2 solutions. I hope this concept is now pretty clear with you. We are going to apply this concept in this question, and this question will be a lot easier. The more difficult the question is, the more easier way is there for the solving, but it will be very conceptual. So let me write down the function x square minus 4 mod x plus 3 minus mod of k minus 1 equal to 0. I will treat this as fx. And I will treat this as gx. So fx minus gx equal to 0. All you need to know is that you need to draw the graph of fx and you need to draw the graph of gx. And your task will be done. So let me add a page in which I will write down fx. Fx is x square minus 4 times mod of x plus 3. Which can also be written as mod of x the whole square minus 4 mod of x plus 3. As you can see, in this particular question, x square can be written as mod x square because as it is a square, positive and negative will not matter. But graphical transformations tell us what? That if there is a mod of x, then the question changes. How? I will let you know. Suppose you have a graph of y equal to x. Everybody knows how to draw this graph. This is y equal to x. But what is the graph for y is equal to mod x? So for y is equal to mod x, first you draw this graph. But this is nothing but y equal to x. This is not y equal to mod x. Then you will have to do one thing. Wherever x is negative, just cut that graph. So you can see, over here, this particular part of the graph is having x negative. So I will cut this. So what will I do? You have to just mirror the right hand side graph. So this right hand side graph will be mirrored over here. And you can see y equal to mod x graph is ready with you. So let us take one more example in which of this question, sine of mod x. Now sine of mod x, but I know the graph of sine of x, which is very simple. The graph of sine of x is like this. But as I have told you, over here we have to draw the graph of sine of mod x. So wherever you have x negative, you cut that particular part. So over here I have x as negative, so I will cut that part. Now what to do later? So you have to just mirror the right hand side graph. So this right hand side graph will be mirrored, and this is your graph for y is equal to sine of mod x. So the basic funda I think is clear with us now. If x is replaced by mod x over the entire function, then what do? Then you mirror the graph from the right hand side to the left hand side and forget the left hand side graph. So for this particular question, I will first of all forget the mod, and fx is equal to x square minus 4x plus 3. This particular graph I will draw. But everybody knows that this is a parabola. So this graph will be like this, and its roots will be x minus 3, x minus 1. So over here 1 and over here 3, something like this. And suppose over here we have the y-axis. Now you can check out this graph more clearly when I draw it on a complete paper. Let us say this is the graph. Okay, now this is 1 and this is 3. But you have to forget the graph where x is negative. Where is x negative? Let us see. Over here x is negative. So you have to forget this. Let us forget. So I forgot that. Then what do you need to do? Complete the right hand side and just flip it, image it on the left hand side. So this becomes your graph for y is equal to x square minus 4 mod x plus 3. Okay. Now I'll give you a very nice demo for the same. So let us go to the app sim where we can have the graph. Okay. Now let me say I am drawing the graph of x square minus 4x plus 3. As you can see the graph over here, this is x square minus 4x plus 3, and over here this particular part x is negative. As you can see, I'll make a very small change. I'll introduce a mod over here. After I introduced a mod for x, see, the negative part of x was gone and the right hand side part was just copied down here. Okay, I think now this graphical transformation is pretty clear with you. Now let us go back to our question. Now our question says that we need 4 real roots, but we also need one more graph for that. The graph was gx equal to mod of k minus 1. So first of all, forget the mod. Let us say we have to draw k minus 1, but k minus 1 is a constant. So y is equal to k minus 1. If it is a constant, it is just a straight line which is parallel to x axis. Suppose the line is drawn over here. Now how many roots? 1 and 2. I am not getting 4 roots. Suppose the line is drawn over here. Again 1. 2. I am not getting 4 roots. Suppose the line is drawn over here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, I am getting 4 roots. Now, till when I will be getting 4 roots? I will draw the line over here also. 1, 2, 3, 4. I am getting 4 roots. and over here I am getting no roots. It means up to this point, from this point I'll be getting 4 roots. Now what is this point that I need to know? Now for this point x is equal to 0, x is equal to 0, and this point is the apex or the vertex of the parabola. So let us have a closer look at it. So f of 0 would be what? 0 minus 4 into 0 plus 3. See, f of 0 is 3. It means what? This particular point is having the coordinate 0 comma 3. And about this, everybody knows for a parabola it is minus b by 2a and minus d by 4a. So let us calculate that as well. So we have the parabola fx equal to x square minus 4 mod x plus 3. So d will be minus b, d will be b square minus 4ac. So b will be minus 4 square, minus 4 into a into c. So it will be 16 minus 12, which will be equal to 4. Therefore, minus d by 4a will be equal to minus 4 by 4 into 1, which is equal to minus 1. It means this particular point has y coordinate minus 1. I don't care about the x coordinate. Minus 1. It means that y equal to k minus 1 line can be drawn from this point to this point. It means y equal to k minus 1 line can be from 1 to 3. Let us have a closer look once again from the graph. Now, then we have to check that it needs to have 4 real roots. So, from here to here, we have to draw the graph. And this particular point is minus 1 and this particular point is 3. It means that horizontal line can be drawn from minus 1 to 3. Suppose I draw a line y equal to 2. See, you can see over here 4 different roots. It means our value of the graph should be from minus 1 to 3 and we are going to get the answer. So let me put up that condition. So this k minus 1 should be from 1 to 3. Then we will have 4 roots. But over here there is a mod condition. I am very sorry, this was minus 1. Let us check once again. This was minus 1. But just to tell you that mod of k minus 1 will always be greater than minus 1. So putting up minus 1 has no meaning to it. So what we will be doing is we will be putting 0. So mod of k minus 1 should be, let us check it once again. Where is the graph? Okay, yes. So mod of k minus 1 line should be from minus 1 to, it should be up to the point 3. So basically k minus 1 line should be less than 3. Okay, because it will always be greater than minus 1, so there's no point in checking this. So we will say mod of k minus 1 line is less than 3. So k minus 1 is less than 3 and greater than minus 3. Add 1 on both the sides, it will be minus 2 to k to 4. It means k lies between minus 2 to 4. It means the answer for the question would be minus 2 to 4. It means A is our correct option. Thank you for watching the video, guys. I hope you have understood that such a difficult question is simplified using very conceptual knowledge. Thanks for watching the video, guys, and do not forget to subscribe to our channel and like this video for more such exciting videos.